The Japanese semiconductor industry's rapid growth in the late 20th century is often remembered as a golden era of technological advancement. Companies like NEC, Toshiba, and Hitachi were leading the global market, thanks to both innovation and a government-backed strategy. The Japanese Ministry of International Trade and Industry, MITI, played a central role, investing heavily in semiconductor research and helping Japanese firms gain a competitive edge through strategic partnerships, subsidies, and technology-focused initiatives. This rapid ascent in Japan's semiconductor industry was perceived as a threat in the United States, which viewed Japan's dominance in DRAM, dynamic random access memory chips, as a challenge to its own technological leadership and economic security. In response, the US government enacted a series of policies aimed at limiting Japan's growth in this sector, framing it as a national security measure. However, critics argue that these policies were a calculated effort to undercut Japan's market share and reassert American dominance. This was the first ever chip war in world history, and until today, it is still seen as one of the biggest blows to Japan's economy. But how did it really pan out? Well, to understand whether the US had really driven Japan's semiconductor industry to the ground, let's first have a historical background. Japan's meteoric rise in semiconductors was initially seen as a testament to its technological prowess. In the early 1980s, Japanese companies produced higher quality DRAM chips than their American counterparts, thanks to a combination of superior technology, efficient production processes, and substantial support from MITI. American semiconductor firms, on the other hand, were struggling to compete, and some, like Intel, even considered exiting the DRAM market altogether. US concerns over Japan's rapid progress were not merely economic, but geopolitical. The Reagan administration took a strong stance, arguing that Japan's semiconductor success was rooted in unfair trade practices, such as market protectionism and alleged dumping, where products were sold below market value abroad. These practices, according to American chipmakers, created an uneven playing field and made it nearly impossible for US companies to compete. As a result, the Reagan administration initiated sanctions and pressured Japan to open its market to American products. The Semiconductor Trade Agreement of 1986 was a pivotal moment, with Japan agreeing to curb its export practices and set aside 20% of its semiconductor market for foreign firms. The agreement marked a significant shift in US trade policy toward managed trade, a departure from the typical free market approach that involved directly regulating international trade outcomes. The Semiconductor Trade Agreement of 1986 is often regarded as a groundbreaking yet controversial trade policy. For the US, this agreement was a strategic maneuver to regain market share and allow American firms to re-establish themselves. The agreement's provisions required Japan to reduce DRAM exports to the US and allow foreign access to its domestic market. It also called for Japan to halt practices that the US claimed were enabling Japanese companies to dump semiconductors at low prices on the global market. Critics argued that the agreement was fundamentally protectionist, prioritizing the US semiconductor industry's needs over free market principles. Additionally, it sparked debates over Japan's sovereignty in handling its own economic policies. Japanese companies, which had invested heavily in DRAM production, were suddenly forced to alter their strategies, reducing their export volume and allocating market share to American firms. By the end of the 1980s, a follow-up agreement extended these provisions. This reinforced Japan's commitments, but also led to growing discontent among Japanese firms. Many saw these terms as a direct intervention by the US into Japan's industrial policy. However, American firms benefited significantly, as the time gained allowed them to invest in new technology and shift focus from DRAM to microprocessors, a move that would later become crucial for companies like Intel and AMD. The impact on Japan was, of course, disastrous. Japan's semiconductor industry, which were global leaders, had been struck by this agreement. Their leading position in DRAM production was a market they had dominated by leveraging cutting-edge technology and efficient production methods. However, the trade restrictions changed the entire story. The requirement to limit exports and increase foreign market access forced Japanese firms to rethink their strategies. As a result, some firms, including Toshiba and NEC, diversified their focus, moving from semiconductors into other consumer electronics markets, such as robotics and digital imaging, which allowed them to avoid direct competition with the US. Over time, this shift created an opening for other players, particularly South Korean companies like Samsung, which capitalized on the space vacated by Japanese firms and invested heavily in DRAM technology. Just take a look at the table on the left. This showcases the profitability of leading electronics South Korean firms as compared to Japanese firms who were taking a hit from the semiconductor agreement, as well as the ongoing global economic crisis at that time. Here's another graph that showcases how South Korean firms grew their DRAM market share from 30% in 1993 to over 40% in 1995. Amidst all these, the South Korean firms were investing rapidly and massively, eating market share from Japanese counterparts. The semiconductor trade agreement set a precedent that has influenced US trade policy with other tech competitors, most notably China. The tech war between the US and China echoes many of the same strategies and policies seen in the US-Japan conflict. Just as the US sought to limit Japan's technological rise, it is now applying similar measures, such as export controls and investment restrictions, to contain China's growing capabilities in semiconductors and AI. The US-Japan chip war provides a compelling case study of how economic and geopolitical interests intersect in technology. Japan's initial dominance in semiconductors and the subsequent restrictions imposed by the US reshaped the global industry. Japan remains a key player in the semiconductor supply chain, particularly in advanced materials and specialized equipment. However, its days of leading DRAM production have long passed. Instead, Japan has focused on niche markets within the industry, a move that has allowed it to remain competitive without challenging US dominance directly. But anyway, do let us know what you think. Thanks for watching.